Islam, the khatib should be the khalifa. We don't have khalifa. The khatib of the Friday should be the grand mufti. But the grand mufti in the Muslim world cannot go from city to city at the same time. So he assigned imams or sheikh, alim, scholar, in the field of Islamic jurisprudence, and he is supposed being having a degree after being graduated and delegated to perform this type of service to the Muslim community in the neighborhood of each and every community. So the khatib himself, that person who is to lead the Muslim in the Friday khutbah and salat, has to improve his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he should make sure that he is doing it for the love of Allah, not for the sake of title, position, or money, or otherwise. He should make sure that he lives also according to the teaching of Islam. He should be a role model. When he speaks something, he should be practicing it, rather than he should never bring a point that Muslim, you should do something when he cannot do it himself. Another thing, he should recognize that he is a da'iyah. Means he is a speaker to invite people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's a hakim and also tabib. And hakim and tabib means he is wise and he should act like a doctor. He should analyze the situation in the society and try to give him prescription. Never ever he should be just scaring the Muslims every minute and then he say haram, haram, haram. You go to hell, you go to hell. No. He should encourage them, inspire them, motivate them, and bring them to the Quranic teaching so as they can live in peace and harmony. And he should never ever point his finger against anyone, even if he knows that somebody is not practicing Islam properly. He should encourage them, inspire them, motivate them to come again and again. That particular khatib, he should have the knowledge of Islamic Sharia. He should know that the Muslims who are sitting, they are not all together from the same country, with the same culture, with the same habit, with the same school of thought. Now even Ahl Sunnah Jama'ah, they may be from Shafi, Hanafi, Maliki, Hanbali. They might be also from Ibadi or Zaydiya. For the Ja'fari, they are from the school of Ja'fari. And they are from different languages. And therefore, he should try to take it easy and he should not tell them only his own school of thought, as if his own school of thought is the only Islam. No, everything is Islam. And all the schools of thought are Islam. And it depends how Muslims came from their Muslim countries and how they are behaving and practicing. And he should accept all of them. But he should be knowledgeable enough to the extent even how to read Quran. It's not easy to say, as I have heard some Muslim khatib, they don't speak Arabic, well and good. They don't speak even Quran properly. How in the world you want to teach them and give them the khutbah if you are not knowledgeable of Quran and Sharia? And a good number used to say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, O you who believe. I said, Allah never revealed Quran in English. Why don't you say, since you are speaking on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you want to quote the Quran, you should quote the Quran in its original language, not in your English language. And therefore Allah didn't say, oh you believe, he said, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. So that is the language of the Quran. He should know how to quote Quran and from which surah. And it's not enough to quote it haphazard. He has to know how to pronounce it properly, how to read it properly, with rules and regulation of makharij and tartil and pronunciation, and rules of how to recite it properly. And therefore the knowledge of Islam and Sharia is a must. The knowledge of the Quran is a must, and the language of Quran, how to pronounce, is a must, and the language of, or the studies of the Hadith, the Seerah. Hadith is the sayings of the Prophet. The same thing. You cannot say our beloved Prophet, peace be upon him, said the following, and you start saying in English. One of the hadiths, my Lord, Allah has ordered me of the following 9 items. But why don't you say it in Arabic? أوصاني ربي بتسع أوصيكم بها. If you don't say exactly the hadith, who narrated even? Abu Huraira? Or Abdullah bin Abbas? Or Abdullah bin Umar? Or who? Therefore, if you want to quote a hadith, also you have to say the narrator as much as the sanad, and whether the hadith is da'if, God forbid, or hasan, or sahih. Is it in Muslim? In Bukhari? Is it muttafaq alayh? Is it rawah al-shaykhan? And all of this, you have to be aware of it before you quote a hadith to the public. And we should recognize that the khatib, as a khatib, the audience who came to pray, old and young, educated, non-educated, men and women, some of them may be sick. So you have to be very careful and very considerate not to make your Friday khutbah 1 hour. Maximum 15 minutes. 10 minutes is the best. And our Prophet ﷺ demanded that the khutbah should be short and the salat could be later a little bit longer. Unfortunately, here many khutaba make their khutbah long and their salat short. So as a khatib, with the knowledge is as important as the outlook. Now, as far as his outlook is concerned, the dress should be with modesty. I do not recommend myself to go and deliver the khutbah when I'm dressed like this. I have to have the thawb, the abaya, the cap, in order that when I'm presenting the teaching of Islam, my dress should be loose. And the teaching of Islam has recommended that the movement of the body bones should not be shown during the performance of salat. So everything should be loose. When you dress a suit like this, of course the movement of the body and the bones are being shown, the movement. But if I'm dressed with thawb, loose, nothing can be shown. And when the khatib should have a beard in order to be appreciated. Because there is sensitivity among some masses of the Muslim Ummah that a Muslim should have a beard, should dress with loose, and should cover his head in order that no fitna or no commotion or no sensitivity among the masses who are coming from different parts of the world. As far as the approach as a khatib, he should be able to inspire the congregation, to motivate them, and to educate them. He should be able to encourage them, to tune their hearts with the love of Allah, the respect of Allah, obedience of Allah, and the fear of Allah. And he should be able to give them hope, he should give them expectation, and he should give them anticipation for their goodwill that they are. By encouraging them to come again and again, they will come. But by scaring them, they will not come to the masjid. And unfortunately, a good number of Muslims don't want to come to attend the Salat al-Jum'ah. They are afraid. Some khatib will tell them, haram, 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 makruh, 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 mashbuh, mashbuh, mashbuh. Everything is haram. Where is the halal? There is no halal. I said, this is not Islam. Everything in Islam is halal. Unless it is being specified in Quran or Hadith. So, my love for anyone who wants to give the khutbah is that he should be able also to encourage them to ask Allah forgiveness and to have repentance. Every human being is liable to make mistakes. And don't worry, all of us are liable to make mistakes. And the best is the one who goes and repent, and Allah will forgive him. Doors of repentance is open. And tell them that Jum'ah in particular, the doors of heaven are open and dua is being accepted. And the best time is in between the two khutbahs. And after the khutbah. And at Asr time before sunset. And the whole day of Friday, the doors of heaven are open, dua is being accepted. And the khatib also should make sure that he should be quoting Muslim scholars' statement in the positive sense. He should never get the sensitivity. This school says this, this school says that, and then confuse the Muslim. No. And he should never get the exception, the exceptions. Never ever bring the exception on the platform. Never ever bring the idea of exceptions, and make sure that encourage them to come, and don't even talk about different leaders of the Muslim world, and don't talk about a particular country, what they are doing wrong or right. Bring them unanimity among themselves. And therefore, don't entangle yourself with the local political issues, rather than encourage them to solve their social, family problem, economic problem. And then when these are being resolved, then you can talk on any political issue in the right, not by accusing one country over the other. That is not part of them. And then my love for you is to encourage the Muslim sister also to come to the masjid as much as you encourage the brothers, and make sure that the mosque in America should have special door for brothers, special door for sisters, and there is a separation between brothers and sisters, and there should be presence of the children in between both, and make sure that you should encourage them. And I hope and I pray that every da'iya, of every khatib should be a da'iya, try to use the wisdom, the hikmah, how to talk to the people, and Allah will bless you, inshallah.